Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me. Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales. Now, Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales is the fifth installment of the Pirates series. Yes, the film franchise that cursed Johnny Depp to play the same over-the-top character over and over and over again. But to be honest, I do have a soft spot for this franchise in my heart. I like every single one of them. Yes, even the fourth one, and at some point I will review them all individually. But now let's talk about Dead Men Tell No Tales. Dead Men Tell No Tales introduces Javier Bardem's Captain Salazar. Because of Jack Sparrow, he was trapped inside the Bermuda Triangle, and now he's out and he's back for vengeance. He is coming after Jack Sparrow with a vengeance. While all this is happening, the movie also introduces two new characters, Henry and Carina. Henry is a young adventurer and Carina is an astronomer. Both of them are looking for an ancient trident. However, that ancient treasure is the only device that can help Jack Sparrow to get rid of Captain Salazar, and the typical pirate adventure fun ensues. Now, as I said before, I like me some Pirates of the Caribbean films. I rewatched all of them recently, and to be honest, yes, the first one is hands down the best. It was revolutionary, it brought back the entire pirate fun and introduced it to a whole new audience. Because back in the day, pirate movies, yeah, they weren't profitable anymore, but now they absolutely are, because this franchise is gigantic. But just like most people, I've had my issues with some of the sequels. But I gotta admit, I had me some fun with this one. First, let's talk about the positives. I like the way this movie looks. Yes, the cinematography in this movie is once again fabulous. I was sucked into this world of crazy pirates from the get-go. The scenery, the costume designs, the way CGI and practical effects are combined, in my opinion, is unparalleled in this franchise. The only real competition that I can think of is Star Wars. And the fact that this time around the plot is not as over-convoluted as, for example, Part 3 or Part 2. No, we have a straight-up treasure hunt, which is everything I ever wanted in a pirates film. And let us not forget about the characters. First up, Captain Jack Sparrow, Johnny Depp himself. I know that Johnny Depp is doomed to play these over-the-top characters now, but Jack Sparrow is the only one that I can give a pass because he just kills it as Jack Sparrow. He's awesome, but sometimes I have a problem with the writing for Jack Sparrow because Jack Sparrow is a shit talker, as smart as he is pretty clever, but sometimes he pretends to be an idiot. However, in the sequels, it felt like two different people were writing for Sparrow. There was that smart ass, that intelligent adventurer aspect, and that funny Johnny Depp-isms, and there was that slapstick cartoony version of a Johnny Depp character. And this time around, again, both of these character traits are in there. Luckily, the positives outweigh the negatives. I'm so glad to see Johnny Depp back again in his signature role. I loved it. Then we got the big bad of this film, Javier Bardem. Once again, he kills it. I mean, Javier Bardem is just a great villain. And this guy is menacing. He is hands down the biggest menace that Jack Sparrow has ever faced. You know, he is not messing around. He will kill people. And he does kill a lot of people in this film. Then we are introduced to Henry and Carina. And the best way to describe Henry is functional. He is absolutely functional for the role he plays. His character motivation is actually extremely interesting as it ties into previous installments of the pirate saga. However, I will not give that away. But him as a character, I didn't find him to be that interesting, but he got the job done. Same goes for Carina, even though I like her a lot more than I liked Henry. But they brought back my favorite character of the entire franchise, Geoffrey Rush as Captain Barbossa. Once again, he crushes it. I mean, that guy just looks like a pirate, like a real pirate. He walks, he talks, he acts like a pirate. And I always love the chemistry between him and Johnny Depp. Their chemistry has always been a centerpiece of the entire franchise because they're frenemies. They like each other, yet they have this constant rivalry going on. And sometimes their paths just cross because they're looking for the same thing. Geoffrey Rush, in this film, he wants to save his crew from Captain Salazar. And Jack Sparrow, once again, wants to save his own ass. So naturally, their paths do cross, and I loved it. And they added a lot more humanity to Barbossa, and every single time they do that, I just love it. I can't illustrate the pirates' adventure fun enough, especially in the third act. They come up with some very creative and visually stunning ideas to make this adventure a truly immersive experience. And without giving anything away, this movie really ties into the previous installments. I mean, you already saw him. I mean, you already saw Orlando Bloom in the trailer. I don't think they should have put him in the trailer. However, I like what they did with his character, even though he's not in the movie as much as you might think. Overall, I had a blast with this film. It did have some pacing issues now and then, and the new additions, Carina and Henry, are not on the same level as Orlando Bloom or Keira Knightley ones were, but they are still enjoyable. I'm gonna give Pirates of the Caribbean Dead Men Tell No Tales the silver medal. Honest to God, it was another blockbuster summer fun. I had a blast with it, but then again, I love me this entire franchise. And for all you guys out there, when you check out this film, stay in your seats, because there is actually a post-credit sequence that made me go, oh, are they really gonna do that? Because it does set up a sequel, and I'm really interested to see where they go with this. Again, I can't really talk about it without spoiling stuff, which is why I will probably give you a spoiler talk at one point. So, Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, have you seen it? What are your thoughts? Let me know in the comment section below, and thank you guys, as always, for watching. And if you like what you see here and you want to see more, then just subscribe.